So now, instead of considering the masses of books, we're going to consider something much more interesting and subtle and I think surprising: the frequencies of words inside of books. So here's a book, and different words appear in it: were and moves and position and so on. And some of these words are very common and appear quite frequently, and other words are much rarer. So what would the distribution of these frequencies look like? So I'm going to illustrate this by thinking not about an entire book, but just a short quotation first. So here is a passage from the writings of Henri Poincaré, a mathematician who helped found chaos and dynamics. And he writes, and I should mention that I'll have a PDF of this slide in the next one in case this isn't readable or you want to print it out and work through this on your own. So here's a passage. The scientist does not study nature because it is useful. He studies it because he delights in it, and he delights in it because it is beautiful. If nature were not beautiful, it would not be worth knowing. And if nature were not worth knowing, life would not be worth living. So let's think about how often certain words appear here. So the word it appears 6 different times in this passage. And let's see if I can find them all. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 6 occurrences of the word it. The word not appears 5 different times. And then there are 4 words that appear 3 times. So like nature appears 3 times. Let's see. 1, 2, 3. There are the 3 instances of nature. There are a bunch of words, 10 of them, that appear twice. And then there are 8 words that appear once. So I've got a bunch of different words with different frequencies. So what I'm going to do now is consider not the words themselves, but just the frequencies. So there's 1, 6, 1, 5, 4 3s, 8 2s, 10 2s and 8 ones. So the word frequencies then are this: 1, 6, 5, 4 3s, and so on. And so I could take these data here, and I could turn that into a histogram. I just count the frequency of occurrences of these different numbers. So let's see what happens if I do that. So I want to make a histogram. There's 1 occurrence of 6, so the histogram for 6 is going to be 1. There's 1 occurrence of 5 and 0 4s, so this is going to look like this: 0 4s. There are 4 3s, 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we had 10 2s. And 8 ones. So this histogram is just derived from this data, which is derived from counting word frequencies. So what this means is that in this passage, there are 8 words that appear once. There are 10 words that appear twice, 4 words that appear 3 times, 0 words that appear 4 times, and there's 1 word that appears 5 times and 1 word that appears 6 times. So what we'll do next is we'll consider word frequencies not for a couple sentences, but for a much, much longer piece of text. So we'll consider the word frequencies from the novel Moby-Dick. So this is a novel by Herman Melville. I have to confess I've never read it, and to be honest, I probably never will, but I have made plots of the word frequencies of it. To me, maybe that's a little bit more fun. But anyway, so Moby-Dick, the total number of words is about 210,000, and the number of different words is about 18,800. So let's think about what we might expect. Are we going to see that maybe most words are used 3 or 4 times? Or are most words going to be used only once or twice? Well, let's see. So here's a result of making a histogram for word frequencies for Moby Dick. The source for this data, I'll put a information here and put a link also on this on the page for this video. So here's what this says. So this is the frequency, and then this is the number of occurrences. So this says that there are, let's see, two, six, something like more than 8,000 words that appear only once. There are around 3,000 words that appear twice. There are fewer words still that appear three times and four times and five times. So most words in the in this novel, or the most common frequency, is one. And then it drops off very quickly. So when you make a histogram, you can count the number of occurrences. You can also think in terms of probability. So here's the same data. And all I've done is I've just plotted the y-axis in terms of probability. So here's what this says. Of the 18,000 or so unique words, different words that appear in Moby Dick, almost half of them appear only once. So I think that's surprising and really interesting. And then about 18% of them, of these words, appear only twice, and so on. So we're seeing something that drops off very quickly and has a really big peak for this small value of one. What does this look like if I go out farther still? Well, let's see. So here I'm plotting not the first, the 30, not out to 30, but out to 300. So how many words appear 300 times in the novel, or 250 times, or 260 times? Well, clearly not very many. Maybe it's zero. It's hard to tell because the scale of this plot, things get scrunched down a lot. So what we'll do is we'll look at a log plot of this. So what I'm going to do is just take the logarithm of the frequency, the logarithm of the probability, and I'm going to plot those. So here's what happens if I do that. So this is the log of the frequency, and this is the log of the probability. And we can see that there's a straight line here to a pretty good approximation. And so we learned in the last unit that when we see a straight line like this, we expect, we saw the straight line a lot when we were doing box counting. So we'd expect that this would be described by a formula similar to that box counting formula. And we'll take a look at that in a second. But first, let me just point out a few more things about this plot. So again, down here, this says that there are a lot of words that appear only once. But what about this word? This is the most common word. It has the largest frequency. And let's see, this is for Moby Dick, the word the. And it appears 14,086 times. So we have a lot of words that appear exactly once, and then we have one word, the, that appears 14,000 some odd times. So that's a really big range of frequencies. That's a lot bigger than the range of book masses that I had before. Let's see, the second most common word, just in case you're curious, is of. Then what do we got? And ah. And the word of appears 6,414 times. And you could look at the data file and get the rest of these. So there are a few words in Moby Dick and in English in general, and this is a general feature of languages, that appear very, very often. And then there are lots and lots and lots and lots of words that appear very rarely in this particular novel only once.